isn't it out of date already? It's a question that I hear all the time from folks on our email list, even new clients asking about certain marketing strategies and methods and approaches and so on. And really, the answer to that question is at the root of what you should be studying, what you should be learning, what you should be focusing on in terms of your growth and development, and what you shouldn't. And that's what I'm going to answer in this video for you. Of course, this is Todd Brown from MarketingFunnelAutomation.com. And over the last handful of weeks, especially over the last week, I've gotten this question asked from a number of different people and kind of from a number of different perspectives. In fact, what you're looking at right here is was given to me. This was a support ticket that somebody submitted, and they submitted the support ticket in response to the letter that we published, like I said, about a week ago or so, about the Big Idea Bootcamp. Now, this particular letter, and really I should say, I know for sure that there are at least two spots left for this. If you haven't read this, you absolutely should read this and seriously consider being at this. I think this event is going to be just freaking unreal, and it's something that's been in the works for a long time. And that's kind of at the root of why I'm really sharing this video. So in this letter, I share a story about how in 2006 I was exposed to something from Michael Masterson, from Mark Ford is his real name, and it became the single greatest, most influential, most impactful lesson, marketing lesson, that I've ever been exposed to. It's the thing that has been more responsible for my marketing achievements to date than any other single thing that I've ever learned. And I talk about the story of being exposed to that, the day I was first exposed to it, and how it sent me off on a six-year journey to better understand it, right, from 2006 to 2012. And so in this particular case, this gentleman asks a legitimate question, a question that I hear all the time. And he says, "Hey, Todd, if it took 6 years, it must be out of date already." And this is the thing that, you know, we're really going to be focusing on, right? But he says, "It must be out of date already. The work we were doing in 2007, he says, and before stopped working after and during the crash of 08 and 09. And now the stuff that we figured out then is not working now due to the increase in volume in online advertising following you around the web." And then he asks for thoughts. And so here is the thing that I want you to understand, right? That is so critical. This is going to help you to separate the things that you shouldn't be wasting your time learning and studying, the things that you shouldn't be investing in terms of personal development, and the things that you should, the things that are going to truly have a profound impact on your marketing chops come a year from now, your income, the size of your business, your earning potential, and all of those things, right? And so at the root of this question, before we can answer this question, before we can really address this question, we need to talk a little bit about the difference between tactics and strategies, because the root of this question lies in the difference between tactics and strategies. Now, you know, globally, let me just say this. For those of you that really just want the answer and want it very quickly, here it is. The reality is that tactics change all the time. There are tactics that worked last month that are working, are not as effective today. There are certainly tactics that worked a year ago that no longer work today, right? There are tactics that when they first hit, like most tactics, when they first hit the scene, so to speak, quote unquote, they were extremely effective. And today they've been just played out and they're no longer nearly as effective. Tactics come in and go out of fashion, right? Tactics become ineffective all the time. Strategies, on the other hand, do not. Strategies are really, if you really want to break it down, right? The way we execute various strategies, and I'm going to break this down for you in just a second. The way we execute strategies are through a variety of different tactics. How we execute those strategies, the tactics change all the time. They evolve as things become less and less effective. But the underlying strategies are always effective. Let me give you an example. Let me move this over here. Let me do this and say that, let's do this, right? So you've got this principle. Let's do this. You've got the principle of scarcity. You've got urgency. You've got reciprocity. Let's do this. Fear of loss. Social proof. These are examples of strategies, right? And so let's say fear of loss, for example, is always going to be a motivator. It's always going to move people to action. Social proof is always going to have an effect on your prospects, making them feel more comfortable with the decision, right? Tapping into the quote-unquote law of reciprocity, if you will, that's always going to have an impact on people, right? And the same thing with urgency, and we could go on and on. Same thing with, if you want to get more into the to Robert Cialdini, right? Commitment and consistency. Commitment and consistency. These things are always, again, because these are strategies. Tactically, we could do this and say, like, so if you look at certain things like Facebook, let's do this. Facebook advertising, or specific methods of executing on Google AdWords. These are tactical elements, right? Studying the new feature inside of the Facebook advertising platform, right? That's going to change. You can study that today and master that today. And there's a chance that in a month from now, it's going to be different. There's going to be a different feature, a different rule. They're going to have changed it. They're going to have removed it. They're going to have added in something new, and it's going to be different. Now, the thing that to understand is, like, if you really want to understand how the savvy marketers are maximizing response from these strategies and all of the other strategies, it's in how they apply them with the different tactics, right? The difference between, and this was something that my good buddy Rich Sheffrin shared years ago with me during a conversation. He said the difference between the pro and the amateur is not in the strategies that they use, right? Because the pros are still using scarcity and urgency and reciprocity and all these things, but is in how they're actually applying those. And the how is the tactics. Right, the how is the tactics, because the way we were providing social proof years ago is online is different from the way we provide social proof today. And so the thing for you to understand, the thing that I really want you to grasp, is that the thing for you to study is strategy, is marketing strategy, not marketing tactics. See, because here's the reality: if you engross yourself in studying, let's say, for example, Facebook advertising, the Facebook advertising platform, well, the reality is that in a year from now, you're still going to have to study that Facebook advertising platform to still continue to be a quote-unquote master at it. Why? Because it is changing and evolving all the time, right? And so not only that, but even if you want to look at more, if you want to look at it on more of a macro level, you may even have to study other traffic platforms, because Facebook advertising might no longer be nearly as effective as it is today. It might evolve radically. They might change the terms of use, terms of services, so that, you know, it can no longer be used by direct response marketers. Who the heck knows, right? So the reality is, if you study tactics in 12 months from now, you're still going to have to study those tactics to maintain your knowledge and your ability to execute that. And so you're not going to be any farther along in your marketing chops as it relates to that particular tactic. But if you study strategy and you master strategy and you master understanding scarcity and when it should be applied and how it's best applied and how not to apply it overtly or explicitly, but how to do it implicitly and how to create urgency, but not do it the same way everybody else is doing it, right? Studying these things are what allow you to radically improve your marketing chops, your earning power, and so on over time, because a year from now, this is going to be the same. The impact of scarcity, the impact of urgency, the impact of reciprocity, the impact of fear of loss, all of these things are never going to change. They're never going to go away. And that's why it drives me crazy when I hear marketers ask the question of, you know, like, of, let's see if we could pull this up, of this. Isn't it out of date already? Sure, it could absolutely be out of date if you're focusing on tactics. But if you're focusing on strategies, right? If you're focusing on strategies, these things are never going to be out of date. And that's why some of the, if not the most valuable marketing books and lessons that you can learn come from the old school masters. It's why if I look at my library, even looking at it right now, the books that are most precious to me, that are most valuable to me, the marketing books that I read literally every year have been published decades and decades ago. You look at a book like Breakthrough Advertising by Eugene Schwartz, arguably the greatest, most valuable marketing book ever published. It's been decades. I think it was published in 1966, if I remember correctly. Then you've got a book like How to Write a Good Advertisement by Victor Schwab. That book was published in 1964 or something like that, or 62, right? Another one of the most valuable marketing books on my shelf. You've got the Robert Collier Letter book. That book was, you know, published, you know, sometime towards the beginning of the 20th century, right? Like 1930 something. You know, you've got Tested Advertising Methods by John Caples. I think, you know, something like in that was first published in the early 70s. You know, so you're talking like, you know, 40 years ago, right? All of these books, right, they not only have application today, but they're the most valuable things that you can actually study and learn from, not the latest fly-by-night Facebook advertising hack, not the latest, you know, trick with, retargeting. It's not the latest evolution of the tactic. It is the strategy behind the tactics that will allow you to just become a freaking master at this marketing game. And so that's why, you know, as it relates to my story and the Big Idea Bootcamp, no, this out of date. This is more important, more critical today than it's ever been, because this is at the root of wildly successful big money campaigns. This was at their root years ago, and this is even more important today because of the crazy noise that people are exposed to. And so, again, you want to make sure that you understand when you ask a question like this that the things that go out of date are the tactics, not the strategies. And you want to focus on all of the different strategies, not the tactics. Hope that helps. I'll talk to you soon.